suspects actually have the apartment complex near the school to loot. And even team number 10, they have a whole city to loot. I don't think they're going to take the risk and try to go for it.
So yet again, it's going to be the Groza, which is going to kickstart this game with the loot and the drops. And he's got a suppressor as well. All the level 3 suits coming out there, the vest, the helmet, as well as the backpack. So the person who's actually going to get that is going to get a whole lot of, recoil as well, along with the drop.
A whole lot of unpredictability in this crate right now, even though the predictable parts are the level 3 gears. And we are going to be looking at team number 8 who are near quarry. I guess they didn't really land in any place in particular. They're just looting all these small buildings in this western strip right there. While team number 13 over at Primorsk, they are also out of the zone. They will when they're making their way inside of the zone, they have to be careful because team number 16 is going to be just a little bit east of Gatka, and Pachinki still not yet monopolized by any of these teams. So if team number 16 or team number 12 decide to move towards the city, I guess they will just get an upgrade to whatever loot they're getting, because team number 12, they're in ruins, pretty sure not getting a lot of good loot, and team number 16 not really looting any of these good places. They are also looting all these small buildings which is spread apart in throughout the map. So whoever goes to Pachinki first is going to be getting an upgrade to the loot. And meanwhile, team number 11 over at Milta, also not in the zone, but I don't think they will be running into any of these players. The only imminent threat to them is if team number 10, who are in Yasnaya, decide to move a little bit south towards prison or something. Other than that, I don't think team number 11 is going to be having any trouble. The one who are going to be in trouble is between team number 9 and team number 14.
But I also feel that if the zone is going to favor team number 12 and 6, they might be under imminent danger as well, because all the teams which are coming out there from the western part, team number 14, team number 9, team number 5, as well as team number 8, will be converging somewhere near school if the zone is going to favor the eastern part of it. As we are going to switch back to Georgia World, where we are going to see team number 14 as well as team number 9 out there, still not picking a fight, which is quite surprising, because by about 10 minutes, usually we do see a casualty or something like that, we see a fight. But this is actually the first time everyone's playing safe, because the stakes are high in this game, as it's going to be the last game in this BO3 semi-finals, and we still don't know who the other people are who are going to qualify. I'm pretty sure team number 9 have it in their bag, probably, if they are not going to exit it pretty early, and if the other teams are willing to capitalize on that, they could probably be out of the tournament. But I don't think that will be the case, given about their track record and the way they have been playing both the games.
I know that what I said previously, that you can't really figure out who is in from which team, but team number 14, maybe it's a calculated decision that they came to Georgia Bowl City.
I mean, that could be the case, given that the name is, they've anyways named themselves like that. And it was quite cocky of them to just go back on to Georgia Bowl, probably because they have won the first two games. And I think that is something which they would be wanting to go for. Probably they were thinking that a lot of teams will be coming out there trying to take them out, so that they will be having a good chance of qualifying as well. So I think they were just more of wanting to go for the kills or something like that, which can also be, that could also be wrong, but...
Yeah,
I think that could be one of the...
Other than playing it safe, it's more like putting out a statement. I'm the strongest team out here. And what better way to...
what better way to do that
by other than getting kills?
Place, exactly.
Other than getting kills and showing off that you are a cocky little team right there. And we are going to be looking at the zone actually converging. Team number 14 and team number 9, they are kind of safe right now. The zone is not going to really be touching them. But team number 9 is in the closest vicinity of team number 14. So, as you said, anytime the fight can burst out right now, as we are looking at Seek Warrior, he is kind of looking at the general direction of where team number 14 were previously, and he's just moving a little bit, inching towards them. And look at that, Seek Warrior is in a really good position to actually go for a flank onto team number 14 if team number 14 takes a fight against the rest of the three players in the city.
And this is actually a good strategy coming out there from team number 9, making sure that just one person is flanking around and trying to spot out and give out some useful information to team number 9, as the others are just sticking around, grouping out and trying to, you know, loot whatever the buildings are remaining out there, while team number 14 are sticking it along with each other, four of them sticking right in the close vicinity and trying to take down the loot and trying to even spot out team number 9, because they pretty much know that there will be a team out there from team either team number 9 will be out there, because given that they have been dropping on to Georgia Bowl, so I feel, you know, anytime soon we will be having a fight out here, because in about 30 more seconds we're going to see the next zone pop out, and who knows, it may even not favor both these teams. So we could even witness a bloodbath out here, right, at the exit of North Georgia Bowl.
And we are going to be looking at both of these teams just gradually inching towards each other. And we see the buildings with the terraces right here. Both of them are actually going to be occupied by both of these teams. So if one of these guys actually spots one of them out, this is going to be a bloodbath. We are going to be looking at Aditya right here on the far western side of these buildings. He is going to be having a really good angle, and we are going to be looking at Unstoppable. He's actually going to be moving into the same compound where team number 9 are, and this is looking to be a really dangerous move coming in from team number 14, because he is the only guy who's going to be straying towards them. And look at that, he is not really giving a damn about where these people might be, as he is just going to be making a lot of noise, just sprinting towards team number 9's general location. I think in about a minute we are going to be seeing a fight between Unstoppable and the players from team number 9, as we are going to be looking at Seek Warrior. He's just going to be inching out, trying to get a peek or two over there, just trying to figure out if people are going to be cutting in between these apartments. We do see the holographic side coming in from the AK, which is a really good setup coming in, because the holographic side just allows you to ADS pretty faster. And we are going to be looking at the guys who are going to be claiming the loot crate over here, are going to be team number 10, the Groza, coming in with the level 3 gear, and Seek Warrior and his friends getting back to them. We are going to be looking at ASD0887. He's going to be inching away. I guess they are not going to be taking the fight right now. They are trying to retreat. He also has an M16 with no bullets, ASD, so not really an advisable strat coming in. I mean, it is kind of intimidating if you run towards someone with an assault rifle, but if you don't have any bullets, I don't think that is going to make a statement, my friend.
But what's the point? You got a 4X onto an M16, but without any bullets, and I think that is suicidal if you are going to go for a fight with that. So what they are doing is probably reasonable, trying to get some bullets and trying to get some good loot before they are going to go. But one more thing which is going to come to their disadvantage is that the zone is not even in their favor. They'll have to move outside Georgia Pole. While we are going to look at the second drop coming into the game, somewhere near right next to team number 8 with the MK14, also the scopes coming out there with level 3 suits. Let's see how it's going to pan out and who is going to take this, because the drop is still inside the white zone. While we are going to see team number 14 making the long way off the western side of the bridge, and they probably could make it towards team number 5 because they are making their way as well. So there is a slight possibility of them trying to meet up with team number 5, probably take a fight or something. Because
you're saying it like they're meeting up for a dinner or picnic or something. I'm pretty sure that they are in for quite a bit of a bloodbath, as we are going to be looking at team number 14. They are going to be crossing these containers in Georgia Pole, which previously was taken by team number 10, and it looks like they are going to be moving towards team number 10, just inching a little bit further towards
them. And it's going to be team number 9 who are coming right behind them, and they are making the same way as well, so we may be looking at a fight over here as well. So because anyways, these guys, wherever they are going, they're being met upon by other teams who are trying to follow them or something. There is a split coming out there from team number 9, two of them dropping out right near the containers part of Georgia Pole, the western side.
There's a small building which people actually go to loot before coming into Georgia Pole containers. If you see a lot of people landing there, that is one of the strats which people, most people do use. And we are going to be looking at team number 9. They're actually going to be getting really close to team number 14. And team number 14, they are in a vehicle, mind you. But team number 9 are going to be split between two vehicles. And with two vehicles,
they are probably going to go and try to take this fight, because team number 14 are right next to them, and they're not even losing their trail, I would say. It looks like Unstoppable is going to fire the first bullets onto them, not really connecting on anyone, but he does give out his location right now. So this is going to be really tricky for both these teams, because should they go for a fight right now, they could lose their chances of qualifying or something like that, even if both the teams are either one of them are going to get wiped out.
And we are going to be looking at the drop getting spotted on by team number 14's player right there. And it looks like team number 9 are going to give no heed to team number 14. They're going to be making their way deeper inside of the zone. And possibly they can possibly contest the drop themselves. But from what I have seen personally of team number 9's place, they don't really go for these drops. They actually just go for most of these kills, they go for most of these safer plays, and maybe in the last few zones, they go ahead and go ham. And we're going to be looking at Aditya and his friends. They're going to be dropping just a little bit close to team number 11. which was in the top two in the previous game right there.
So we're actually going to see the top two fight of Miramar again right at the start of the game. So let's see how it's going to work out for both these teams, because we saw this fight which
Seek went down between Arcady. That's
exactly
the one you guys got to look out for.
Because that is the one we saw in the previous game, and it was going right down to the wire, and I'm expecting something of that sort coming out there from both these teams. Both these quality teams coming out first and second respectively in the previous game. We can see something like that, of that sort of caliber coming out there between both these teams, because both of them are right next to each other, and it looks so massive. Sick one has got that car right inside the garage, stealthily coming inside as Aditya is making his way on top of that building, and little does he realize that there are people out there and they could be in for a fight at the moment, as Sick one is trying to cover his teammate out there right opposite to the building where he is from team 11, while team number 9 are safe in that building. So Nate's going, the Nades are going to get cooked out out there, but Dawood from team number 11 and Captain Bond and Aditya are trying to make their way over there. Seek Warrior trying to give a cover to all his teammates. Let's see how it's going to work out. Team number 11 have a play right at the team number 10. Team number 9 are right on the opposite side of the building, as Dracula is going to try to bandage himself and then go for his Nades as well, because he's got a lot of them as well, as so does his teammates. So I think this is going to be a good fight coming out there from both the sides, as Nate is going to go and try to throw those Nades right now.
Is that a wordplay, Tando? Nate and Nate. Okay, okay, yeah, that is not really a common thing, but we are going to be looking at Sea Quarry. He's just going to be, as you said, giving cover to his teammates, and we are going to be looking at Sea Quarry with his signature B4T, and he does have that 6X to pair it up with, so he is going to be a formidable opponent, and look at him, he's just scoping into most of these random things.
And while this is happening, we just realized the team number 13 are out of the tournament, so that is going to be the end of the run for their game right now. So let's see if they are going to finish in the top four, because that is something we'll just have to wait and watch, as we are coming back to the fight between team number 9 as well as 11.
And we are going to be looking at Captain Bones. He's just going to try to get on top, but we are going to be looking at one player from team number 11. Out of it, he's going to get knocked down right now, and we are going to be looking at Aditya. He is going to be the criminal who did that, and we are going to be looking at one more knockdown possibly going to be coming in, and that is going to be Aditya with two knockouts, and two more people remain. Maybe cook a nade or two and try to throw that in, but it does not look like team number 9 have a lot of nades. And we are going to be looking at Captain Pons. He is going to be making his way to the building, and it looks like Seek Warrior is just going to be the designated sniper. He's just trying to keep some cover, and we are going to be looking at another knockout coming in consecutively from Aditya.
That's going to be Kavish, who's going to fall down. The guy who was going to go and who eventually revived at Dawood, he's going to go down as well, and let's see how it's going to work out, because Arcady was going to the flank, and I'll be surprised if he's going to take down three people like he did in the previous game, because let's face it, this was almost the same situation which was in for team number 11, and they were almost able to take that out of nowhere, and it looks as if team number 9 are in advantage right now.
And by the way, look at Sea Warrior finds out Arcady. What is this? This looks like a replay of the last map, as we are going to be looking at Sea Warrior actually getting the knockdown onto Arcady. So we are going to be looking at the flank gone wrong coming in from team number 11. This is the right moment for team number 9 to actually pounce onto that building, because one of their players is knocked out and way out of reach for team number 11's players. We are going to be looking at the mini 14 coming in from Sea Quarry. He's just looking at most of these angles, just trying to figure out if any of these other players are going to be stupid enough to try to go for a flank. Then we are going to be looking at team number 11. They're just reviving their teammates again and again. Arcady, he even has a mini 14 himself with a 4X, but he, look at that, he only got one bullet in, and Sea Quarry just knocked him out with that headshot. And
this is going to be really hard for them if they are choosing to, you know, leave Arcady out there, because that is going to really not help them out in the rest of the game, because if they are going to go and try to take a fight right now, they'll have to be without their MVP of the previous game, which happens to be Arcady. It looks to as if one of their teammates are going to go. It happens to be Kavish who is going to go and try to revive him, and that is going to be a revive in favor of them, and Arcady is going to heal himself up. And this is the time where they are going to decide whether to take the fight or not, because three of them have already been knocked out once. So if they're going to do it a couple of times or something like that, that is not really going to help them out, because already they are sitting in second place in the standings, and if they are going to lose out pretty early into the game, that is not going to really help them out, because if the teams which are finishing on third and fourth in the previous game are going to win this or come in the top three or four, that is going to be the end of the road for Too Easy Gaming. So can we see something like that, or is this going to be a fight between both these people, and Too Easy Gaming are going to redeem themselves with this fight, while we are going to switch between team number 5 as well as 14. Shots fired there from Leon on team number 14's players, one of them getting damaged for a little bit, which happens to be Magician God, already one kill into the game for him.
number 11, taking that kill. And
look at that, that's going to be 4 kills for them as well. So this is some valuable points coming into them. While team number 9 just wanted to get outside the zone.
Look at that.
It's going right in the city of Pochinki. And that, by the way, is one of the places I really don't want to have a fight or have the last 2 to 3 zones out there. Team number 8 trying to spam the hell out of team number 5 where they are going by the vehicle, and they are heading right inside the blue zone. That's going to be a lot of damage onto them, and that's going to be Shin Shan who's going to go down because of the blue zone. This is quite a bad decision coming out there from team number 5, as that's just going to be one person alive from them. He's going to go for the revive, and he's going to go come.
I think Leon is dead.
He's going to go down. Yes, he is down.
Even though Sunnote did fire plate really well, he managed to get knocked down. And look at that. We are going to look at Kebab right there getting knocked down by Kitsuka Tencho, an anime name coming up again from team number 8 right there. And there is one more player from team number 12 right there, Hari, and he is going to get spotted out by Kitsuka right there. And we are going to be looking at the shot coming in from the SKS, and that Atex getting paired up, and Hari is also going to get knocked down, and that is going to be team number 12 getting knocked out of the tournament right now. And we are going to be looking at team number 8. They are kind of close to the white zone right there, but the place where they have to go to, that's a lot of open space, that's a lot of open fields. And looking at team number 16, they have a really good angle, and Viper XL, he's actually looking in the general direction of where team number 8 might just emerge from.
I mean, he can spot out two teams, team number 8 as well as team number 6, because the way he is at the top of that building, he can spot out both the people, one being team number 6 from Pochinki, because he's got a really good scope as well. I think that is a 6x, so that is going to be a 6x onto a Mutant MK47, so that is something which is the M16 alternative of the 7.62 family, as we are going to see team number 16 heavily guarded at this place, and this can go either ways, because if you are going to get naded out in this building, that's going to be the end of your game. And let's actually see how it's going to work out, because this building, they are right under the zone as well.
I think team number 16 are going to be one of the safest, are going to be in one of the safest places, because nobody is really in the closest vicinity of them. And look at that, team number 6 and team number 16, there's a huge difference that they have to cover to actually be an imminent threat to them. And it looks like team number 8 are actually not going to be going towards team number 16, but team number 8
on to team number 6, because they're going heads on to them. And let's see whether this is going to be a fight between both these teams. Mind you, it's going to be a fight between a team which has 4 people alive and just 2 people alive for team number 8, and looks though as if it can be picked up anytime soon, because the one thing which is covering both these teams is going to be the Cliff West Maester is there from team number 8. So that is going to give some kind of cover for them, as Paradox is right in front of him, and looks though as if both of them are not able to spot each other out there, courtesy of that
little tractor right there. And we are going to be looking at the Maester right here with that M4 and that extended Mac. He is going to be going towards him, but he needs to be careful. I think he is going to spot him out in a little bit if he just gets a little bit ahead. But it looks like team number 6, they are going to get all shacked up, as they are going to be making that little place their home. And this is quite an amazing play, because there is a watchtower right next to them, and team number 8 might just assume that they are going to be in the watchtower, but no, they are not. They are going to be in that shack. And look at that, Kitsuka Tencho and his friend, they are going to be looking at,
they actually spoiled out team number 6, and that's going to be some damage on to Minded Monster. Let's see whether they are going to get the job done, because they little do they know that there are a couple of guys from team number 6 inside the shack, so that is going to be an element of surprise for them. And let's see whether they can actually get to it. But I guess the door closing out there is going to give them some kind of information that there are people more inside that shack, and that's going to be one of team number 8's players getting shot out there from team number 6. And Minus Monster and Master XX making their flank out there, going towards the left, and let's see whether they are going to go for the fight. But no, they are going to go inside the building and get some cover. Probably that will buy them some time for them to heal up, as this battle is getting right under Pochinki right now. The next zone is going to favor the teams which are team number 10, 11 as well as 6, and team number 9 are still into this game, and they are diagonally opposite to team number 11. So we are still yet to find who is going to be the victor between both those teams, because we will be seeing that pretty soon, because I really think both of them have an equal chance of getting a victory into this, because heading into the zone and the zone favoring them as well is going to add as another advantage for them, because in about 5 more seconds we are going to see the next zone going to move up, the blue zone going to move, and that will force team number 9 to get inside the zone. And I feel it's going to go right near team number 11, as Kavish can be the first guy who will be giving the information to team number
looking at captain spawns coming in from team number 9. He is going to be inching just a little bit closer to Covetous position. Zeke Warrior, as usual, with the holographic side onto the AK, just pairing it up. Like, tell me a better love story than an AK and a holographic side, because even though the red dot is one of the best close-range scopes, the holographic just has that little bit of an ADS speed, and that is going to act really good coming into the game. And we are going to be looking at team number 11. They have spotted out team number 16's position, as we are going to be looking at Dracula with that 6x onto that SKS. Will be able to fire a bunch of shots, but I don't think he's going to be landing any of those. Joker 07, on contrary, with the 3x onto that Scar L, he's just going to be making some little bit of a noise right there.
Boy, but that is going to allow team number 9 to get that vital information that team number 11 are just hiding somewhere behind those buildings. And I think Nate as well as Aditya have spotted one of their players, and Arcady is going to be the guy who is going to try to flag and try to spot out the people, as team number 16 are finally making their way on Pachinki, while team number 6 and 8 are still not fighting against each other. So they probably are playing it really safe, as we still have just about 6 teams and 22 people alive in this game. And it can go either ways, because all of the teams are inside the zone. I think the first fights between the teams is going to be between team number 11 and 9, something which we saw at the end of the previous game and the start of this game.
The El Clasico of PUBG Ace Operator League 2019.
Semi-final 3.
And we are one of the things which I wanted to talk about, since the zone did come into Pachinki, is the usage of nades. I believe that team number 9 used most of their nades back when there was a fight, and we are going to be looking at nade actually getting a knockdown onto Arcady. So we are going to be looking at the star player, the MVP for team number 11, getting knocked down right now, but I don't think he's in any imminent danger, as we are going to be looking at Dracula. He's going to be going for the revive, and team number 9, they're nowhere close enough to team number 11 to actually close down on that knockout situation. And we are going to be looking at team number 6's players. They are going to be just inching a little bit closer towards the city.
It's going to be one of team number 10's players who's going to go down courtesy of one of team number 9's players. So let's actually see who's going to work on, as Joker is going to take down Paradox. So as and when he was trying to get inside the building, one of his teammates just closed that door, which was allowing him to just get knocked out there. And so Dawat is going to get revived there. 4 kills for their team. Team number 11 are not in a great position as of now, because the zone is not favoring them.
They actually got knocked down twice by team number 9. And look at that, team number 9 have actually not stayed in that same position. They have actually moved deeper inside of the city, and this is quite an amazing thing that they are doing right now. And this is, mind you, the 3-story building in Pachinki, where you can actually look out into the terrace. And this is,
I'm not sure how it's going to work out right now, because they are heading right into the open, and team number 10 have a really good angle. And look at the team number 16 are going to pick up a fight with team number 9, but team number 6 are right behind them, and Sick Warrior with their smokes is going to act as a distraction between both these teams, as he is making his way out there. He is spotted by Airtaker and a couple of guys from team number 6. So this is going really crazy at the moment, as Sick Warrior is still having a sight on team number 11's players. So there are going to be shots which are going to get fired onto Arcady, which is going to connect, and Johnny Walker is going to get that knockout as well. So that's going to be the third or fourth time where he is going to get knocked out, which is going to do a lot of damage, which is not going to really help him out in the later stage of the game, because we are going to Arcady is going to go down, and that is going to be the end of the MVP of team number 11, as Nate is going to spot out a couple of guys, and Ramoth is going to go down as well. And Ramoth is going down, and Asif is going to take down Joker. What is going on? It's going to be a triple threat between three teams of the team number 6, 11, as well as 16 are fighting it out, while team number 9 are waiting and baiting out the other people. So Sick Warrior still has his eyes on Johnny Walker. Let's see whether he can take him out as well, as Aditya is going to spot out the people from team number 10, as Asif is going to get taken down by 143 from team number 10. And we are just with 5 teams into this game, and 17 people alive, and a lot of people getting knocked out there, getting revived as well, as Asif is going to be the only person from team number 6 who is out of the building. And his teammates have got a long way to go if they want to go and try to revive his teammates. And if they want to go there as well, it's going to be team number 16 who are going to stand right into their way. And Captain Pawns out there from team number 9. Team number 9 are playing it really well, as each and every one of their teammates are actually, you know, spotting out each of every side.
They just know how to play this really calculatedly, as we are going to be looking at Nate. He's holding an angle onto team number 11's position, while Aditya, he's just looking towards another direction, while Nate, he knows he needs to worry about team number 16. While we did see a little bit of a scuffle between Sick Warrior and Johnny right there, so Johnny Walker, so this is kind of a tough situation for team number 9, but their superior game sense is showing off in this game, as we are going to be looking at team number 9 essentially getting sandwiched between two players from team number 11 and two players from team number 16.
This is brilliant. Team number 9 in one building, team number 16 in the next one, and towards the left side is team number 11, two people from team number 11, and it's going to be team number 10, Skrava, who's going to take on Paradox from team number 6. So this is the most time where we are going to see the next fight coming out, and about 50 more seconds we are going to see the next zone, which is going to form up as this one is going to go out right now. So let us see how it's going to happen right now. It's going to be a couple of kills for, it's going to be a couple of numbers for team number 9, as Kavish is going to go down, which is going to leave Dracula, the last person alive from team number 11, and that is going to give him a lot of responsibility at the moment, because if he's not going to try to get that, that would be the end of their team in the run, as it's going to be Midas Monster who's going to go down to one of team number 10's players. They're playing it really well. Team number 10 are going to be the team which we have to watch out for. But as I say that, two people from team number 10 are going to go down, and it's going to be Hemchand who's going to get that naked out there, and he's going to wipe out team number 6. And what a game this is. It's just down to 12 people or 11 people out here, as Hemchand is going to go down. Finally, team number 16 and team number 6 are making team number 10 pay for it. We are just left with four teams into this. One person from team number 11, four people from team number 9, three from team number 16, and just about two people, or I guess three people from team number 10. So this can go either ways, because all of them are right next to each other, except for team number 10, who are right on to the opposite diagonal side of team number 16 as well. So it's just four buildings between all these four teams.
And the ones who are in the advantage are going to be team number 16. They are in that building, and since the zone is going to be converging towards the center right now, this is going to be one hell of a match right here.
And speaking about the advantage, it looks as if one of team number 6's players, one of team number 10's players, is going to 16's players is going to get knocked down courtesy of team number 9's player. And this is going to be really tricky right now, because in about 16 more seconds we are going to see where the next zone is going to go out. It is going to diminish in the point of the center. So this is going to be really tricky, because all the teams will have to go down or go for a fight right now. And it's going to be one more person for team number 10 who is going to get knocked out. We're just going to leave Skavav as the last.
I killed it, it's murder. Go crazy, berserker. I killed it, it's murder. Go crazy, berserker. I killed it, it's murder. Go crazy, berserker. Show them. Crazy berserker.